With what shall we compare the kingdom of God? Or what can we use to talk about the kingdom of God? This morning, Jesus teaches us in parables, which are not the same as fables. Fables teach us a life lesson, a truth about life. Parables, the wonderful thing about parables, Eugene Peterson, he's a Presbyterian pastor. He recently wrote a translation of the, or worked on a translation of the Bible called The Message. If you've never seen it, you should look for it, because it puts the Bible into plain English for today. It's kind of like the New Living Translation, but it's a newer version of it. And it's really interesting. It brings to life the scriptures. But Eugene Peterson refers to parables as time bombs. You hear it, and you go away from it thinking about it, and it's something that just nestles with you and stays with you, and it works on you day in and day out like a slow little, or a time-release vitamin, right? You take it and it doesn't all release at once. It's something that takes a while, and then it hits you, and you go, oh my gosh, is that really what that meant? Jesus today talks to us about the kingdom of heaven being like someone who goes out and scatters seeds. And then wait. And I had to think about this for a moment, because I'm not a farmer by any stretch of the imagination. If you would have seen my garden last year, you would have known that I'm not a farmer. So, but my grandfather was, and my uncle is, and my father was. So I know something about farming. And you don't just, farmers, right? You don't just go out and plant your seeds and just wait. Right? It doesn't happen that way. You don't just go out and plant it, put it in the ground, and just let it go. Go to sleep, rise, and just hope that everything works out okay. You actually worry about enough rain or not enough rain, as I spoke to one person yesterday about all of this. You know, the fact that now that everything's been planted and the ground is so wet, is anything going to come up because of too much water? Right? You worry about it. You put stuff on it. I don't want to say chemicals, because we put things on it to keep the weeds away, right? Because we want the plants to grow and not the weeds. We don't just throw the seed in the ground and then just wait and hope. This first parable, we look at it and we think, oh, this is good. It's about faith and how we have to just wait on God, right? That's what this is about. It's about the fact that God plants a seed in us, or someone plants a seed in us, and then that seed is just grown by God, and we just have to wait on God's timing. Yeah, this story could mean that. It could also mean something else. So when Jesus talks about parables, he talks about them in ways that we try to put people into the story. The best thing that we do is try to put God in. And God is the one who scatters the seed. God is the one who waits. God is the one who then goes out and does the harvest, right? Which one is it? Is God the one who does all of that? Is God the one who harvests? Is God the one who waits? Or is that us who scatters the seed? Do we scatter the seed and then wait for God to do all the work? Which is exactly the way the kingdom of God is. And it's exactly the way that all of our lives are. See, this story is not about us waiting on God. This story is about the fact that our faith and the gift that we get from God in grace and the gift that we get from God in the kingdom has absolutely nothing to do with us. God's kingdom is going to come regardless of anything that we do. God's kingdom is going to come in spite of the things that we do to keep God's kingdom from coming. God is the one who does all of the work. Yes, we get the joy and the pleasure of scattering seed, but God is the one who brings about his kingdom. You see, it's something that happens regardless of what we do, of how much we worry, or how much we toil, or how much we think that we can do in this. God's kingdom is a gift given to each and every one of us. Then there's the parable of the mustard seed, right? The smallest seed on earth that grows into a mighty shrub. Anybody else have a problem with that? A mighty shrub, really? I mean, our first lesson was about the great cedars of Lebanon, right? The tower over everything, right? These massive, marvelous trees. How many of you have ever been to see the redwoods in California, right? No. Oh, good. They're massive, marvelous trees, aren't they? They're wonderful, towering creations. But Jesus says the mustard seed becomes a mighty shrub. It Exactly. Really a mighty shrub. He plants the smallest seed and God grows it into something great and wonderful that the birds can come and nest in and the woodland creatures can come and take rest in, right? It's a wonderful story about how God takes something small and turns it into something wonderful or something that He uses for His kingdom, right? Is that what that parable is about? Remember that parables are not easy life lessons. They're more like ticking time bombs that go off when we least expect it. Yeah, it could be about that, and it probably is about that. But there's something more there. See, what is mustard? Does anybody know anything about mustard? It's a plant, and it grows. It's hard to kill. It is not kosher. Who is Jesus talking to? Jews. And He's telling them about planting a plant that is not kosher. Think about that one for a minute. It's a weed. And it's very invasive. It's like mint. You plant a little bit of it, and in a couple of years, that's all you're going to have. It's not a shrub or a plant that you would plant around the edges of your garden or along your driveway or around your property for something to be beautiful to look at. It's something that farmers in Jesus' day would have fought very hard to keep out of their fields. But yet here He is talking about the kingdom of God being like a mustard plant. Something that we try to keep out of our lives and of our gardens. Jesus talks about the kingdom of God being so pervasive and so incoming and so overpowering that it doesn't matter what we do, that it's going to come. And that it's going to take over everything, regardless of what we do or how we act. The kingdom of God is something that is in God's hand and in God's control. And it comes in God's time. Yeah, we have to wait on it. And yeah, God takes something small and makes it something big. But that's not what this is about. Jesus is telling us that the kingdom of God is a gift to us to live in and to be a part of. And that God is going to use us to help scatter those seeds around and then He's going to bring the growth in everything. And that He's going to take these small things that happen and He's going to grow them into something big and wonderful that the birds of the air can come and nest in. And we think about that image, right? And we think that it's a great and wonderful image for us to see. We even have a cute little picture in our bulletins. Open up your bulletins. There's a cute little picture there of the bush and the birds in it, right? It's a wonderful thing, right? You think about it. Oh, it's so nice and warm and fuzzy. The thing that we missed last week, we didn't have the parable that Jesus gives to His disciples right before this one, which was the scattering of the seed, right? The seed caster who goes out and casts seed, and some of it falls on the path and is eaten by the birds. Could the birds in our mustard bush be the same birds that just ate the seed off the path? Maybe these birds are the people that the religious society or the religious leaders don't want to be around, right? They're the ones that come in and snatch away things and make it harder for the kingdom of God to come. They're the undesirables, right? Because think about it for a minute. Who did Jesus surround Himself with? Fishermen, tax collectors, prostitutes, the desirable people of the community, right? Not at all. They were the derelicts. They were the people that nobody else wanted around because those were the people who actually heard His message and understood what it meant. They opened themselves up to the fact that God's kingdom is coming and that Jesus was telling them about a new way and a new radical love that God had for each and every one of us, not because of the rules we had to follow. If God's kingdom was a commodity that we could buy or sell, it would come in a box. And I bet you that there would be warning labels on it. One of them would say this: use only in moderation, because if you use too much of it, it could cause problems, right? Or how about this one? warning. The kingdom of God may be hazardous to your health. Because the kingdom of God comes in and has a way of changing people and changing your ideas about life. It's not something that we can put into a box and make it be what we want it to be. God's grace is not something that we can hold and use and maneuver to the points that we want it to take and do the things that we want it to do for us. God's kingdom comes in and moves us to do things that we didn't think we were going to. Like quit a job in computers and go to seminary. Or move around the country how many times to how many different places. God's kingdom comes in and it takes a hold of you and it makes you do things that you never in your wildest imagination would think that you would ever do. And that, my friends, is the gift that God gives to each and every one of us. So the parables this morning that Jesus tells us about the kingdom are not supposed to make us feel warm and fuzzy. They're supposed to set us on fire with the kingdom of God that's alive and living around us everywhere and help us to work in and through that and allow God to use our lives to help spread that message more. You can't till the ground. You can't weed the people out that you don't want out. Our job is to merely scatter seeds and to tell everyone about the wonderful love that God has given to each and every one of us and the place that we can come and take refuge. And then allow God to work in and through them. To be so overwhelmed with the kingdom of God and the love that we have that we're just like a little child who pulls off that dandelion for the first time and comes up running to you. Isn't it beautiful? And all you're thinking is, oh my gosh, all that's going to do is spread weeds all around. But that's the excitement that we have to have. Knowing that God is going to take those weeds and turn them into something beautiful. That God's weeds are God's creation and the love that He shows to each and every one of us. So don't get rid of the weeds. Live in and among them. So that they too can see how much God loves them, just as He loves you. Amen.